السماء والأرض وما بينهما باطلا ذلك ظن الذين كفروا فويل للذين كفروا من النار أم نجعل الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كالمفسدين في الأرض أم نجعل المتقين كالفجار.
Time. One of the most important concepts universally, Allah Azza wa Jalla talks about it in many verses of the Quran, and one of them is in Surah Asr, where Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillahi r-Rahman r-Rahim, wal-Asr, inna al-insana lafi khusr, illa al-ladhina amanu wa amilu al-salihati, wa tawasaw bil-haqqi, wa tawasaw bil-sabr." That by time, Allah makes an oath by time, that inna al-insana lafi khusr, indeed mankind is in loss. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. Except for those who have believed and done righteous deeds and advised each other to the truth and advised each other to patience. So by default, for a person to be able to master the time and to try and be as productive as possible is to occupy yourself by doing good deeds, by remembering Allah Azza wa Jal. And there are so many ways to do good deeds, you know. You can go and do some extra prayers, you can go and do some Quran revision, you can go and do whatever you want, as long as obviously it's in the right, correct Islamic methodology. So this is one of the ways to really occupy your time. And again, when your soul, when your heart, when your brain, when your body, when all of these things are feeling good, which again, by the way, comes from the heart and from the soul, you start to be more productive. When you have that sort of sense in your life, one thing I realized personally is that it really, really makes you unproductive. When you're, let's say, you're not doing the Quran revision, or you're not being the best person, like all of these things, every single sin that you do, wallahi, it starts to like sort of put you down, and it really makes you a person who wouldn't be as productive on a normal day. So one of the things that I personally say to myself is, on a day where I'm not as productive as I would like to be, I say to myself, why exactly is this the case? And one of the reasons, in fact the main reason, is because maybe that day I'm not doing as many good deeds, maybe that day I've been falling into sins, and all of these things make a person spend their time in, you know, things that don't really benefit you. And again, when you do sins, the timing out there is like literally like 1 hour would go and you'll be like, I've done nothing in that 1 hour. And when you're, alhamdulillah, when you feel like your iman is there and you're making your dua, you're doing all of that stuff, sometimes, I don't know if it ever happened to you guys, but you sit down for 1 hour, but you get so much work done, as if you had like 2-3 hours. That barakah in time, that blessing in time, the way that blessing comes is by asking Allah Azza wa Jal to make that time be very, very beneficial for you. So try to be very, very careful with your time, and try to really incorporate the good deeds, your early Quran revision, your morning adhkar, your evening adhkar, your sunnah prayers, your obviously your fard prayers, and also try to pray here and there some of the optional prayers, and try to do all of that stuff to make sure that you are incorporating and you're indulging yourself with the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. And again, this is a reminder to myself first and foremost, and then to you guys, and may Allah allow us to benefit from it. So I wanted to talk about social media distractions, and I don't even know why I'm sitting down here trying to give you some advice on social media distractions when I'm probably one of the worst people when it comes to it. Like sometimes you just scroll down endlessly and you just see things and you're like, oh, let me watch the next one and blah blah blah, and then your time basically goes. And screen time and, like, you know, using social media and stuff like that is definitely one of my weaknesses. So one thing that I have been though implementing is, again, for example, you guys know my company page, my business page, at Abu Educate. Basically what I do on that page is I very clearly like stated, as at least to my friends, that this is a business space and is literally for me to just do my business stuff and, you know, just follow people, stuff like that. I'm not there to like speak to people unless it's for business purposes. So this is something that I have been implementing, which does sort of minimize the time that I spend on Instagram on my business and stuff like that, because most of the times I want to go on social media to make content, to sort of try to benefit people inshallah, and to also, you know, earn some money and try to see what career can I go into and all of that stuff. But sometimes you end up scrolling like unnecessarily and endlessly, and before you know it, half an hour, 40 minutes, 45 minutes, 1 hour is gone. And one of the ways for me to do that is by trying to only go and log in onto the accounts that I actually use for business purposes. That's why I've got different YouTube channels, that's why I've got different Instagrams and all of that stuff, so that every time I go on a specific account, it's for that specific job and it's not for me to go and waste my time. Another thing is, for example, if you guys check my TikTok, I don't even have that many followers, but I do upload here and there. One thing that I do on my TikTok, for example, is I follow zero people. I don't follow anyone at all back. Yeah, and one of the reasons why is because I realize when you start to follow them, you're then gonna sort of watch their content or speak to them and whatnot. Basically, time is gonna go. So one thing that I have been implementing is try to not follow as many people on Instagram or other social medias, unless you're trying to, you know, follow and unfollow to get a few followers to grow your company, whatnot, right? But other than that, try not to like unnecessarily get to know so many more new people, because that's gonna take a lot of your time away. And on top of that, me personally, I like to like meet people in real life rather than, you know, behind the screen. So that's the sort of person I am, and I feel like it's just more fun. So usually whenever I go to the masjid or to the uni, literally I know most of the people there, so I just go and speak to them, socialize there, and I don't sort of feel like I need to socialize as much on social media, if that makes sense. So that's definitely one of the main tips that I would give, especially because a lot of people have been asking me, TikTok, Instagram, oh, I'm too addicted to it. And I feel like a lot of people, especially the youngsters, tend to face this problem, especially in the 21st century. But may Allah make it easy for us. And as I said, you have to put your trust in Allah, but you have to put the effort in as well. If you're sort of going randomly, just use so much social media, it's not going to work out. You need to make sure that you sort of try and control yourself and try to set measures that you can follow, inshallah. So I also wanted to touch upon this idea of little time blocks throughout your day. And these time blocks, what they allow you to do is, let's say you spare about 2 hours in the morning by waking up a little bit earlier, going to the toilet, doing everything a bit faster, and then you save up, let's say, 2 hours in the evening, and then you use these time blocks to sort of do something that you always wanted to do and try to be as productive as possible. Now bear in mind, this doesn't have to be 2 hours, it can be even up to 20 minutes, but we're talking about in a long term, what's going to happen is that these time blocks are going to try, they're going to be like stacking up in front of you. And by the end of the year, even if you set aside like half an hour in the morning and half an hour in the evening to do a certain specific action, then you will start to see the progress in a couple of months time, and let's say in a year or two time, you're gonna be like, whoa, I was there and now I'm here. And this is one of the things that I have personally spoken to a lot of Hufaz about, people who have memorized the entire Quran. And one of the things they did tell me is that you have to respect the time that you give yourself. For example, half an hour in the morning, half an hour in the evening. A lot of people might say, oh, it's hard to memorize Quran, it's hard to memorize Hadith. But in reality, it's not. The thing is that you are restricting yourself and you're not giving yourself that time and you're not being consistent with it. What you do need to do is remember, even if you do good deeds in like small amounts, what are the best good deeds? They are the ones that you can basically go upon and try to be consistent about them. So the hadith and all of the links of all of the stuff and some additional articles will be down there in the description below, inshallah, so you guys can go and check them out. But again, this goes back to the point of the time blocks. Set some time blocks early in the morning or maybe some late at night and try to stick to that and try to literally do the thing that you always wanted to do and the thing that you know find hard to do. Just give it a go, and just half an hour, even 15-20 minutes, start off slow and then see where that takes you. I also wanted to touch upon the idea of multitasking. Now I've sort of have like mixed feelings about this, like multitasking, but I thought, you know, maybe I should just mention it. And one of the things with multitasking, for example, whenever I'm tutoring, and usually every day, even now at uni, I'm trying to tutor 3 to 4 hours average and try to do 28, close to 30, maybe a little bit less usually, depending on exam season and whatnot. And one thing that allows me to do this is that during my tutoring time, yes, I'm trying my best to teach the people and I'm trying to give them work, explain and all of that. But at the same time, whenever I give work to my students and I say, okay, do these questions and get back to me in 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes once you've done them, one thing I would do during that time is try to multitask. So I'm tutoring, earning money, and at the same time, I go quickly, I look at my lecture notes in 5 minutes, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I have my lecture notes open and I try to revise at the same time while sort of tutoring. And I also edit a lot of the times while tutoring, and all of these mini clips that you guys can see here and there, most of them are actually literally edited while I'm tutoring. I literally save them up and I say, when I'm tutoring this student or that student, I'm basically gonna try and edit them here and there. And another thing that I do is, for example, reply to emails and all of that stuff. So multitasking, to a certain extent, it actually does help me. But as I said, I have some sort of mixed feelings about this, and one of the reasons why is because multitasking doesn't always work with a lot of the stuff. So if I'm looking at my lecture notes, it's because I'm doing it as a revision sort of stuff. I'm not learning new content. Like, learning new content while tutoring and all these other things going on in your head is not easy. For example, when I'm doing my muraja, when I'm doing my Quran revision, you wouldn't be using your phone and do your Quran revision, and then because all of that stuff will sort of take the attention away. So multitasking, as I said, mixed feelings about this. Sometimes it works pretty well, in fact really well, and sometimes it just doesn't work as well. Rather sitting down and doing one task at a time sometimes seems to be better. But as I said, this does depend on people, and not only that, this sometimes depends even on the environment and the situation that you're put in. So I wanted to, you know, just mention a little bit of multitasking just to see if you guys want to try it out or not. Now again, when it comes to time, we need to ask Allah Azza wa Jal to give us that barakah, that blessing, so that we can use our time in the best possible way and in the best possible manner. And again, I'm one of the biggest time wasters out here, so I don't even know why I'm talking, but honestly, may Allah make it easy for us and allow us to really use our time in the best possible way. And yeah, that's basically it. But other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed, and most importantly, I hope you guys benefited from the video. And again, may Allah make it easy for us. And honestly guys, when it comes to time, it's a madness with uni work, with all of this other stuff, with wrestling, jiu-jitsu, gym, all of that. It's like, it's literally getting to me. But you know, alhamdulillah, just keep on going and try to keep yourself busy, because you know, it's better to be busy than, you know, not to be busy. Because when you're not busy, all sorts of, you know, mad ideas from the shaitan and stuff like that, the waswasa and all of that just comes to your head. So try to keep yourself busy, surround yourself with the right-minded people, the people who do remind you of Allah Azza wa Jal, and just keep on doing your thing and just keep on going guys. Honestly, keep on grinding. And again, I'll see you in my next video inshallah ta'ala. And yeah, that's it. Take care and
assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.